Thank you so much, Mr. President. Okay, so it's a great pleasure, it's an honor talking to all of you as presenting the data of this very important initiative that we have developed with the Russian Society of Endoscopy. So everybody knows that quality colonoscopy is a very important concept in modern endoscopy because of the screening program for colorectal cancer. This has a huge impact on the incidence and mortality for colorectal cancer. And bowel prep is one of the most important parts of the preparation of colonoscopy. It's impacting in our ADR, in our ability to diagnose also advanced adenoma and early cancer, and has also financial implication. So these are the statements from the European Society of Gastrointestinal Endoscopy. It's very important because this society has worked very hard in the past to define the most important items for quality colonoscopy, and since Russia is part of the European Society, I'm very glad to discuss these items with all of you. And as you can see, when we talk about quality colonoscopy, bowel cleansing should be at least 90% at a good level in patients undergoing colonoscopy for screening colonoscopy, and also for screening program. And also there are several other items that should be considered, including sedation, adenoma and cancer detection rate, and also technical issues like colonoscope withdrawal time. So, why colonoscopy is very important? We know from many years, from many publications, that the patients not undergoing screening colonoscopy, they are not protected against development of colorectal cancer. And in many Western countries, as well as in Russia, colorectal cancer still remains the second cause of death for cancer, and this is something that we can really prevent just using quality colonoscopy and trying to work with our patients and with the institution to prevent the cancer. So, in general, colonoscopy is considered one of the most important medical procedures because it's the one that altogether with the breast cancer program can prevent patients for developing colorectal cancer. So it's very important that also in Europe we focus the issue of prevention and screening for colorectal cancer. As you can see from this slide, every 3 minutes there is in Europe one patient who is dying because of colorectal cancer. And also very important to know that when we do X-ray colonoscopy, when we perform quality colonoscopy, we may diagnose early cancer and we can remove endoscopically. Professor Pochon said very nicely that ESD has a great potentiality in removing early cancer, especially at colorectal level, and this is associated with a very, very safe outcome in the long term, very comparable to surgical data. So, but this is the situation of endoscopy in Russia. Still, Russia is a country where you perform more upper GI endoscopy than lower GI endoscopy. It's been estimated that in Russia, upper GI endoscopy is performed 4 times more frequently than lower GI endoscopy. And it is different from the rest of Europe, different from the rest of the Western countries. And also, when we discuss about quality colonoscopy program, a screening program, we don't know exactly how it's working in Russia. This is why, several years ago, discussing with the board of the Russian Society of Endoscopy, we have decided to establish a quality colonoscopy program from the beginning here in Russia, and we are very proud to present the results that have been published in the last year on the UEG journal. That was the first report of data on outcome of colonoscopy in a large series of patients. And this is very important because the outcome of these colonoscopies have been recorded in a prospective manner. So we recorded data on more than 8 1,000 patients undergoing colonoscopy in Russia. These are the inclusion and exclusion criteria. We just selected the centers with a high volume of colonoscopy, and we just collect data from two physicians per center to try to have as much as possible reliable and consistent data, and we try to exclude all patients undergoing emergency colonoscopy. So the aim of this prospective multi-center nationwide collection of data was just to measure the main outcome, the main indicators of quality colonoscopy in this country. And this was involving about 14 centers across the entire country. And it's the variables that we have collected. You see variables at the patient level, at the colonoscopy level, performance level, and also data on pathology. There was the website, there was a web-based registry, and now we are ready with the second edition of Quacol. It's Quacol 2 that has been discussed yesterday during the meeting on quality colonoscopy, and I'm quite sure that this is another very successful initiative under the Russian Society of Endoscopy. So there was the study population, and this is very important. This is the ADR. As you can see, there is a huge variability of ADR across the different centers, with an average of about 15%. And this is very important, something that we need to work with, because still the ADR is quite low. But this is not different from Italian situation. This is a paper published a couple of years ago, and when we recorded in Italy the ADR, we saw this exactly the same situation. This is important because, as Professor Pochon said before, we need a guide to follow the guideline, but we need also a training just to define how to diagnose the polyps, how to use electronic chromoendoscopy, how to use conventional chromoendoscopy. Because you can see also in Italy, a couple of years ago, we had the same huge variability in terms of ADR. So if you look to this data, the ADR was about 18%. If you compare with the rest of ADR in Europe, I would say that was one of the lowest ADR ever recorded in a prospective study. So it's very important that we, as a physician, and you, as a part of the Russian Society of Endoscopy, work very hard in trying to improve the results in terms of ADR. This is a summary of the all data. It's very important to mention that we were very happy about the safety. So colonoscopy is a very safe procedure in Russia. We didn't record any serious adverse event over the 3 months of period of registration of outcome. The other main problem was the bowel prep. So bowel prep wasn't good. Only 77% of patients had adequate bowel prep. So it means that one third of the entire population undergoing colonoscopy were not well prepared. And this is a big interaction with the ADR. And what was even more important, that only 25% of patients undergoing colonoscopy used the split dose. So this is clearly stated in the ESG guideline. When you do bowel prep, first you must split. If you do not split, you cannot get the 90% of patients with excellent bowel prep in your screening program. So, and also split preparation, cecal intubation, and also the withdrawal time measurement were strictly related, were predictors of high detection rate. So when we look to the data of patients in Russia, colonoscopy in Russia, we can see that the most important predictor of low ADR was the poor bowel prep. So I think this is a sort of interconnected question. So low ADR and poor bowel prep, I would say this is the bad connection in Russia colonoscopy that we need to work with. And It's very important, you see, when the colon is very clean, because we have used a split preparation, split dosage, it's very easy to recognize tiny lesion and also to characterize this lesion using electronic chromatography. So, and again, when you have such very clean colon, you can differentiate hyperplastic from adenomatous polyp, you can do a sort of optical biopsy, you can decide which lesion has to be removed. And again, can you make the video running? Sorry? Can you run the video? Again, you see when the bowel prep is very nicely prepared, you can recognize the lesion. And when you try to characterize the lesion, these IBD patients, this was a huge dysplastic area. And when you use electronic chromatography and optical zoom, you can nicely characterize both the big pattern and the vessel pattern. And you know, when you have a dysplastic lesion in a IBD, you have to proceed with a block resection. But just to proceed with a block resection with ESD, you need to have a very clean colon. So this patient is being prepared with a split dose. Without split dose, you cannot do any advanced tissue resection procedure. You cannot perform safely ESD, because if you get perforation, there is the risk of peritoneal contamination by the stool, by the fecal materials. So it's very important when you do tunneling of during ESD, as in this big lesion in long-term IBD, it's very important that you work in a very nice and safe environment. So how to improve the bowel prep and the polio colonoscopy? So this is our experience in our hospital. You see, we moved progressively from the 4 liters to 2 liters. Why? There is a matter of compliance. The patients, they don't want to drink too much. So we progressively moved to the 2 liters bowel prep, so the low volume. And if you look to the, this is the Boston score in our hospital. It was quite poor a couple of years ago. So it was keep improving. As much as we were keep using the low dosage, the 2 liters bowel prep. So I think that this is something that must happen also in this country, because when we look to the data about the compliance of the patients, patients are not happy to drink 4 liters. And we must admit, especially if we don't split. It may be acceptable if we split, but if we do not split, 4 liters the day before, it must be almost unacceptable by the patient. So probably from Quaffle 1 program to Quaffle 2, I do expect that most of you will be moving from 4 liters to 2 liters bowel prep, so we can increase the number of patients with adequate bowel prep, and we can increase also the adenoma detection rate. So I do believe there is no doubt anymore about the efficacy of, efficacy of the low volume bowel preparation. There are many data, especially with the Movicol. It's clear that the efficacy is very similar to the 4 liters. It is also true in terms of cleaning of the right colon. And when we look to the compliance data, of course, all the patients are much more happy to use the 2 liters rather than the 4 liters. And split dosing is improving ADR. This has been very clearly demonstrated by our Italian study in cooperation with Cesare that we published last year on GATT. So in the screening program colonoscopy, we randomized patients with the Movicol, and we say that the day before versus the split dose. And when you look at the data about ADR, when you split Movicol, you can get as high as 53%, which is about 3 times higher than the ADR that we have recorded in Russia. So my hope is that you are moving to split dose with low volume, and I do believe a new era is opening. We are moving from Quaffle 1 to Quaffle 2. Everybody who wants to participate to Quaffle 2 program is to refer to the Russian Society of Endoscopy. They have already established a new web-based program, a new web-based platform, and we are ready to go with a lot of passion and dedication, and thanks to the Russian Society and to Professor Korolev for this support. Thank you.
Благодарны вам за этот проект. Спасибо.